Welcome back. Beautiful blue skies over Sydney to top off our long weekend. A chilly morning in our west. Richmond, the coldest, falling to 4 degrees. Top temperatures right on average for this time of year, reaching 18 or 19 in our west. The city also stopping at 18, just 1 degree above the June average. But it felt 3 to 5 degrees colder thanks to that wind chill. Westerly winds turning southerly this afternoon. Sydney staying fine, along with most of New South Wales. Just a few scattered showers, mostly over the central west and tablelands. Parks recording the highest rainfall, but only 1.4 millimetres. A cold morning for northern parts. Grafton dropping to 3, more than 4 degrees below average for this time of year, and gusty along the coast, a top of 15 degrees for Batemans Bay and Bega. Tomorrow, a vigorous cold front will move across the southeast of our state, bringing cold and blustery conditions, showers as well as snow to the Alps. The Bureau has issued a severe weather warning from early tomorrow. Damaging wind gusts around 90 kilometres per hour are possible for elevated parts of the Snowy Mountains as well as the southern tablelands. We also have a warning for hazardous surf around the Hunter and Sydney regions on Wednesday. That system also hitting Canberra tomorrow, a frosty morning dropping to 0 with showers increasing and a top of 12 degrees. Windy with showers for Melbourne as well as Hobart. Brisbane in the clear though, another sunny day and 23. Adelaide and Perth also expecting some showers, a warmer 21 for Perth and Darwin, a top of 28 degrees and partly cloudy. Back home to New South Wales and Bathurst and Mudgee falling below 0 overnight. You can see those showers developing across the southern inland and ranges. Snow developing on the Alpine peaks above 1500 metres in the afternoon or evening. Fine and mostly sunny across the north. Bourke, Grafton and Coffs all heading for 21. A strong wind warning is in place for coastal waters around Byron and the south of the Hunter. That includes Sydney, partly cloudy skies with 15 to 25 kilometre per hour northwesterlies in the middle of the day. Our west, a little cooler than today. Campbelltown only making it to 16, 17 or 18 for the rest. And the city heading for 19. And you'll need a warm coat in the morning, a low of 8 in the city and 3 to 6 degrees in our west. On to the rest of the week, a cooler 17 degrees in the city on Thursday. Staying fine until Friday. Then just a possible shower on Saturday and Monday. No sign of any showers in our west. Tops hovering around 16 to 18. But thanks to the clear skies, plenty of more cold mornings on the way, Pete.
Belinda, thank you.
Hello again. Melbourne has had perfect weather for a winter holiday. The clear skies meant it was a brisk start to the day with a low of 5 in the city, but the sunshine warmed it up to 16. Some parts of Melbourne had an even colder start to the day. Werribee, Epping and Ringwood dipped to 3 degrees. Then this afternoon, most spots went on to reach 14 or 15. Werribee and Avalon joined the city on 16. Western parts of the state had a frosty morning and Bendigo was the coldest spot away from the Alps, falling to -1. It warmed up into the high teens through the Mallee, but generally the low teens elsewhere. A high pressure system cleared out the cloud that's been over Victoria for the past 2 days, but there's been more pushed in from the west by a cold front. Winds are also picking up, and around midnight the shower activity is set to arrive in the west before extending across the state tomorrow. There'll also be fresh and gusty winds both ahead of and behind that system. Damaging wind gusts are expected to develop across the Macedon and Otway ranges later this evening, and from tomorrow morning, the Gippsland ranges and across elevated areas. That system will reach Adelaide tonight with up to 15 millimetres of showers expected there tomorrow, up to 10 millimetres for Hobart, but a mild top of 15. Frosty morning in Canberra, then a chilly top of 12 degrees before showers arrive late in the day. Dry further north, a partly cloudy top of 19 for Sydney, sunny and 23 in Brisbane. Back home, showers will develop in the southwest of the state shortly after midnight with up to 10 millimetres forecast. Generally lighter falls elsewhere, but up to 15 millimetres for Warragul, 35 at Mount Hotham, and that is expected to fall as snow at night. The windy conditions will keep minimums above average for most of the state, and daytime temperatures will also be a little higher than today, generally maximums of 15 to 17. Parts of Melbourne are expected to stay in double figures overnight, but we will wake to a wet and windy morning with gusts of around 60 kilometres an hour, easing during the afternoon. Daytime temperatures will generally be higher than today, mostly 15 and 16 degrees, just 13 at Coldstream, 9 at Fernie Creek. The showers are expected to develop in the early hours of the morning, contracting to eastern suburbs in the afternoon before clearing in the evening. There's 10 to 20 millimetres forecast in the east, a little less than 10 through the west. Up to 6 millimetres for Geelong and a top of 16 degrees. The city's forecast a dip to 11, then also heading to 16 with up to 10 millimetres. A shower or two early on Wednesday and quite a bit colder, just 13 degrees. Brace for it, a top of just 12 on Thursday with a shower or two. Then some brighter days and a run of 14 degree maximums through to next Monday with a very chilly morning on Saturday, down to 4 degrees. But a nasty day on the way tomorrow. Showers developing overnight and becoming very windy. A low of 11 and a top of 16. A wet and windy Tuesday.
Oh, it certainly is, Melissa. How good is that? The Story Bridge lit in green and gold. There'll be multiple landmarks around the city this week lit up in green and gold. Of course, it's all part of the Australian swimming trials that kicked off right here in Brizzy today as we count down to the Paris Olympics. But you can catch all the action live and free on Nine, and again, we'll hit the pool from 7:30 this evening. Now, how good is winter in southeast Queensland? Talking of swimming, if you want to jump in the ocean, it is pristine at the moment, clean and still 22.5 degrees. Now, it's a little bit warmer than what tomorrow morning's temperature will be. We'll get to that in just a moment. Let's have a look at temps recorded across southeast Queensland over the past 24 hours. And a bit frosty inland this morning. We had lows of -1 recorded in Warwick and Oakey. We had 2 degrees in Ipswich this morning, 11 here in the city. Daytime temperatures were slightly up on average, 23 in Brisbane, 24 the top in Ipswich, 22 for Coolangatta and the Goldie, 23 Redcliffe, the Sunshine Coast, to 17. The weather map, strong wind, showers and rain gradually easing over South Australia, southern New South Wales, Victoria and Tassie. With a passing cold front, there'll be welcome snow for the ski fields. They should see about 20 centimetres in the next 24 hours and maybe another 10 into Wednesday. They certainly need it. For the capitals, showers in Perth and Adelaide, windy and wet for Melbourne and Hobart tomorrow, frosty morning for Canberra, early cloud in Darwin, clearing to a top of 28 degrees. Now, Queensland tomorrow, sunny and dry across the entire state. After a cool morning, some early fog and frost patches inland for Roma. Now, Cairns, Townsville, Mount Isa and Longreach expecting high 20s. Mackay only low 20s. The Capricornia, Wide Bay and Burnett in the mid-20s. But beautiful blue skies for Tuesday. Here in the southeast, some early fog around the Lockyer Valley, followed by a sunny day, light winds right across the southeast. Overnight temperatures ranging between sort of 4 and 10 degrees. While daytime highs, well, we're looking at low 20s, up to about 23 for Burnett, Beaudesert, at Gatton and Ipswich. Moreton Bay, south-southwesterlies, 10 to 15 knots at first, easing in the middle of the day. Brisbane, sunny, light winds, a low of 10 and a top of 23. Your 7-day outlook, sunny and warm Wednesday, 24, the pick of the week. Sunny Thursday and only 21. Mostly sunny and low 20s Friday, Saturday and Sunday. Ipswich, warm on Wednesday, up to 25. Then back to low 20s for the rest of the week. Sunday should see up around 23 degrees again. But some chilly mornings for the Goldie. Wednesday, the pick of the week, 24 degrees. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, tops of 21. Sunday, sunny and 22. Sunshine Coast, sunny Wednesday, 24. Mostly sunny for the rest of the week. Light winds and low 20s. Sunday, back up to around 22 degrees. So, looking good for the rest of the week. Just a little bit fresh in the mornings, but how good is that Story Bridge this evening?
Today, we had the top of actually over 20 degrees, so it wasn't really that cold at all. And even now, it's still around the 18 degree mark. And then around the suburbs, we did see certainly cloudy conditions. The cloud cover has been building up ahead of that change coming through. But, you know, quite mild. We had temperatures up around 22 degrees through the northern suburbs. Just 14 degrees at Mount Lofty, though. We had some really warm weather up through the north of the state today. It was 27 up at Cooper Pedy and over at Ceduna. In the south, we made 20 degrees around Victor Harbour and Keith. Now, there is an unmissable change on the charts here for us. The big front sweeping through, set to bring a whole bunch of rain, pretty much from even later tonight, possibly, and certainly into tomorrow. Interstate, that front could bring damaging wind gusts to Tassie and a wet 15 for Hobart. Melbourne and Canberra also looking wet when that change arrives tomorrow. For South Australia, the rain is not really stretching too far into the north. Maybe a light splash around Port Pirie, but basically dry from Whyalla up and through the south. Well, that's where it's all happening, really. Many areas could see up to 10 to 15 millimetres up for grabs there. And the small risk of damaging winds about the lower southeast coast. In fact, we do have gale force wind warnings in place for the lower southeast coast tomorrow, and strong winds possible for many other coastal regional areas there. Not so bad around Adelaide though. We're looking at north to northwesterly, so 20 knots turning westerly in the afternoon. And then around the suburbs, look, it's a pretty big change from today. We do have the rain coming in. Tomorrow will probably be the wettest day of the week, and I'd say the heaviest areas could potentially be around the western slopes of the ranges heading up into the hills there, up to around 15 millimetres possible. And temps are coming down to around 19, 18 degrees on the plains. In the city, we're talking really anything from 3 to 10 millimetres. We'll have to wait and see exactly how much rainfall we do get. Our temperatures are aiming for 19 degrees tomorrow, and then on the 7-day forecast, we basically just keep taking little steps down with the temperature for the rest of the week. So we go from 19 to 18 to 17 and to 16 to round out the week on Friday. The chance of showers remaining on and off over the next few days, and then potentially ramping back up again for the end of the week. But hopefully you've had a fantastic long weekend. It's goodbye from the West Beach Surf Life Saving Club, and get ready for that rain.